I started to think like, oh gosh, how are they going to cast younger versions of everybody? And then I met Sophie, and you know, you do have blonde hair and blue eyes, and we don't really look that similar, but there is something energetically that works.
A lot of people say we have sort of the same essence. I don't know, we relate to Shauna in the same way, or we just picture her the same way, but I was like, I don't look like her at all. There is no way I'm getting casted in this. We went automatically through the whole process of like the contact lens fitting and dyeing the hair brown. And I remember when we did the table read, I'm sitting down and Melanie starts speaking and saying her lines. And I'm just like, you speak quite like higher pitched than me. And I freaked out and I was like, there's still time to fire me.
Karen was very worried about my voice, Karen Kusama, the director. And she kept saying to me, your voice has to be deeper. Sophie's voice is deeper. Like, Sophie, I think I was the one who was in danger of getting fired, not you. We're really like, you got to change your voice.
It's what, to this day, shocks me the most when I watch the show is how I do think that the resemblance quite works.
We don't have like a Shauna Bible. We don't have like a handbook of how to play Shauna. But yeah, I felt like Sophie and I feel like we're both very instinctive as actors. Like, I'm not somebody who plots out every little moment and, oh, on this beat, I'm going to like turn around or, you know, like for me, that would be something I'd be trying to remember in the back of my head. Mm. I feel lucky that we didn't have to worry about it.
Although there are things though that you do that I've noticed that I didn't know. And now watching the show, like I just the way like, you bite your lips quite often and like we kind of move the same. There's like this awkwardness of the way you move your body, which I'm like, I have noticed. And I'm not going to like try to drastically change it now in season two for younger Shauna. But they're like little moments that I'm like, I've picked up on. And I'm like, oh, it could be nice if I just added a few more in.
Shauna just yet. Yeah. It's funny you say that actually because I started – a similar thing, like after watching the table read, like there would be times when Sophie would be doing a scene in the table read and it would cut back to older Shauna and I'd just be like mesmerized.
I knew that you were basing your acting off of my table read performances. I would have tried to do it a little better.
Whenever you have a confrontational moment, you're very still and you're very direct. And I was like, oh, I like that because I can kind of like do a lot of things and I stole that from you.
Oh, so like, we kind of met in the middle.
Yeah. I was like, I think that older Shauna should do the same thing and be able to deliver something with a lot of stillness.
The darkness was, I think in our opinion, kind of always there, which is why this character is so complex. There's always been this like really dark side to her that she's been trying to like push down, but it's also what makes her so human and real. And we all have darker sides. They're all different. They all come up in different ways. And I don't think that's a result of like trauma or her situation. I think this situation has helped her let this darkness come out.
Well, I know that we both have such a similar sense of who this character is. And I think that that's such a big part of it, like how we carry ourselves, how we move, how we interact with the other characters. There is something that happens when we're playing this person where I think it feels like the same person. The writing is so good. There's so much that's in the writing inherently. And you kind of see from the pilot, I feel like you really get a sense of like where she's most comfortable. Like, younger Shauna at the party is miserable.
I'm sorry for what I said before about you.
I didn't, you know, mean to hurt her.
Okay.
Uncomfortable, everything's awkward. Younger Shauna alone with Jeff after they drop Jackie off is, like, quite intense. Like, she feels a lot more herself, like, asking for what she wants, and it's like kind of an amazing shift.
Jeff, pull over. Tell me you love me. I won't hold you to it, okay?
That's a thread that kind of continues, and it was just all on the page, so we never really needed to have a conversation. But, you know, I feel like older Shauna is not comfortable being like PTA mom or whatever.
Hey, honey. I thought you were at Alana's.
Came home to change.
Okay.
Lucky for you, or Dad might have found this first.
She's most comfortable doing things that are darker, like sneaking around. You know, she's just not a person who's like cheery and easygoing, and she's having a very hard time pretending to be.
What I love about older Shauna and the way that Melanie's done it is that she brings so much light to the show. And I think the show is great because it taps into horror and comedy, but I think you levitate the show and make it, even though it's not always written like funny, you bring so much lightness and funniness and reality and humanity to the character. I love the scene where you're pretending to be this like hot, like after like the therapy session.
Oh my God.
Pardon me.
And you like are like about to have sex, and it's just like just the awkwardness of it all is like palpable, and then how like quickly it spirals down.
I'm Tabitha.
Well, it's a real pleasure to meet you. Is there anything special that I can help you with today, Tabitha?
Actually, yes. I'm here to make a return.
Why would you be returning something?
I don't know. Not as like a... I don't know. Just a... My armoire. It's too big. I should have taken measurements.
Are you making fun of me?
No.
There's just like so many subtleties in this moment, and like it's so just captivating and fun to watch you. Even the darker scenes, they're just like fun. You embark in the character, and it's great.
Okay. All right. I think I should leave my clothes on because I don't think I would go shopping without them.
Yeah.
Yeah.
I think that Sophie had the hardest job of any actor on the show. I would read the script and just see like what was required of you. There's so many huge moments that you had to play, and you're just like on fire. You're so present. You're so real. You're so grounded. You have this like ferocity to your performance and this focus. The scene like with you and Jasmine, the like attempted abortion scene. There's so many layers to that, and you really like, you just played a million things at once, and it was so heartbreaking. You play desperate, like, fear for your life, the tragedy of what was happening, the shame of what was happening, the, like, loneliness, and then, like, the need for somebody to be there for you. Like, it's just such a complicated moment. I look up to you as an actor, like truly. I watch you and I'm just like, she is unbelievable, like howl from your soul. And I just was like, all right, she's the best. She's just the best.
It's very hard to receive so much compliment, but we have such admiration for one another. Like when Melanie won the Critics' Choice Awards, I kid you not, we were sobbing.
It was such an overwhelming moment for me, but to look over at you all and like I almost lost it.